Yo, mama! Mama, this one for you, mama! Oh, baby, baby, I wanna phone, you know.
Lobot, Empire Strikes Back. Lando Calrissian, Cloud City, his helper, the guy, the bald dude with the computer around his head.
Chewbacca!
The main reason is to instill fear in the opponent. Because, basically, in Quake 2, they used to have these things called Z-Bots. Basically, as a type of bot that aimed for you, it automatically aimed and killed things. Everyone hated them, so everyone hated a bot. If you used a bot, people hated you, and people, you know, you're good. If you're too good, to some people, they accused you of being a bot. And Lobot is Star Wars, and I love Star Wars, so hey, it's perfect.
I swear, I don't care if it would fucking get me out of hell in the afterlife. I'd not fuck another guy. I swear, if you're like that, okay, whatever, you might as well fucking mash my balls under a fucking steamroller because I ain't gonna fucking do it, you know? I don't care, it's fucking wrong, man.
What about for
it's, 100? It's Adam and Eve, not fucking Adam and Steve, right? But anyways, I don't know, no, I'm fucking rambling. I gotta, like, stay coherent. I gotta, like, think about one thing. I will admit, I am a person that does not take losing well. Fuck! How many jobs have you had where you got a fucking raise after 500 hours? I played this one character long enough to get a fucking raise at a job. I've spent over 1,500 hours playing that game. Let's take 1,500 hours, let's divide that into days. I'd like to know how many days I've wasted of my life. Oh my fucking god, man. That's over 2 months.
Your life?
Of my fucking life! 24-7, man. I'm playing EverQuest. Holy shit. How many crackheads can say that?
Where it is?
Stay away from EverQuest! I'm ruining your life.
Punk. Metal, I guess. I don't listen to music while I play, though.
No?
No way. I need the sounds of the game. People dying is my music.
Remember your very first Quake map?
Yep.
That me and Dave tested out? You fall in the lava, you think you're gonna die. Then you pick up the pentagram, you're just sitting there. In the lava, it's too deep, you can't see anything, you're just sitting there. And you have to sit there for like 40 seconds.
You should film somebody else.
Look at that rotisserie of meat. Tell me what it looks like. It's meaty too.
The objective is to pretty much kill everything that's not you.
Put it a nice way, it's paintball on the computer, yeah. Go around killing. Hi, bitches!
Scott.
You don't like to say killing because moms hate that shit.
You're killing people with them!
They gotta say, you splat them with their paint pellets until they fall over and die.
Yeah! No!
It's a social gathering.
But we're all so harmless.
We are harmless. I mean, shit, we just have fun.
Hey, why don't you lick my balls, lick balls?
Come on, bitches!
Huge, throbbing, like, 15-inch python, he was, like, kissing the end of it.
That was sick.
Drugs, computers, and cyber culture?
Yeah, we do kind of have all that.
Quake. Nobody can ever be unhappy about Quake. There's gotta be a 13-step program for this game.
Online, my first experience with online gaming was Hack and Slash. Remember Hack and Slash? Hack and Slash rules.
Yeah, we used to play it in Moses.
Played on the DDS.
Connors.
Door games. Yeah. Connors Back Alley.
Oh my god, you've got a 14-4.
Yeah, Rob was late with his 14-4 connection. I don't think Doom was played online at all, like over the internet. Maybe a little bit.
It had a
Cali. Yeah, it was with Cali and
stuff like that, but it wasn't big for over the internet. It's mostly played on LAN.
Yeah, so. Quake 2 is all kind of like, I don't know, a lot of players can play it a lot more like sly and stuff. You can like look around corners and stuff. Quake, I swear, it's just like, what can you do? Like, you know, like walk, like stick a grenade while you're running away and then like watch jump up somewhere and like blah. It's like somebody watching Quake can be like astounded and like made to throw up if they're not used to looking at 3D game. And Quake 2 is like, I don't know, Quake 1 on Valium.
Okay. I agree. Quake 3 is a conglomeration of a lot. Doom, Quake 1, and Quake 2, the best of kind of thing. That's why it's such a great game.
Spring 2000. Mobot is preparing to attend the Razer CPL event in Dallas. This is the largest Quake tournament to date, boasting over $100,000 in prize money.
I think I'm at a good age right now. One, because I got the money to afford a trip to Dallas. Two, because I don't need my parents around. I can do whatever the hell I want when I want, you know, kind of thing. Not like a lot of these other kids. But right now, I'm set. I've got my job. My career job, you know, it's great. I love it or whatever, and so all my free time I can dedicate to Quake without worrying about other responsibilities kind of thing. So I think I'm at a good age right now to do well.
Tournament coming up, the one we're going to, is basically the start of it all. Like, this is the first big money event, so if this goes well, the corporations like what they see, it's just going to get bigger and bigger.
If I ended up going down there and I won, like, the lowest amount of cash, which is like, what, coming in 16th or 32nd or something like that? I'd be pumped, man. I think it's like $800 or something. That'd more or less pay for your whole tournament.
32nd.
That'd be sweet.
Do you think you'd be able to make your name in Dallas?
Oh, I'm open. If I have a name to be made, it's going to be made there.
I think it's cool that like someone from our gang is good enough to compete in these big-time gaming things. I mean, we've always known that the group in Edmonton is really good, but to have one of them kind of go and fight against all the well-known names is pretty cool. I think he's got a pretty good chance.
See, that's my advantage. I think going to this tournament is I'm very underrated and no one really knows if I'm good or not, and I kind of want to keep it that way.
It's gonna be huge.
Who should I worry about?
Yeah.
Wise guy, cancer, who else? Oh yeah, the guy Chief, this guy Blue. Oh man, it's gonna be tough. We'll see.
What clan is Wise Guy from?
Abuse. Yeah, they're alright. Man, oh, I'm scared now. Yeah, and that Blue, it's the guy from Europe. Oh well, it'll be fun. If I get knocked out, I'm getting loaded. Every day. I was 10 frags behind, and I figured, in 2.5 minutes, you can't make up 10 frags with those kind of
players, you know? I thought they're too good for me to make them. Because the whole time I was trying to make ground and I couldn't, the whole game.
I didn't think I could win whatsoever.
I was in fifth from beginning to end, basically. It was only right at the end that I actually pulled it through. And I don't know, I just all clicked, I guess.
Oh, no.
I'm just fucking flying, man. I can't believe I pulled that out. Man, I wouldn't be pumped like this if I would have won, got first or second or third.
Yeah.
I was 10 frag, or 10 frags down with 2 minutes left.
Yeah.
I thought there was no way. I look up at him. I'm like, sorry, man. You know? Turn around. Last second, I got one frag and it was on the castle.
Oh, man. I saw that, yeah.
So if he would have got that kill, he would have won.
I feel so bad for cancer.
He was leading all the way too.
Yeah, he was. He was
third and fourth.
Yeah. Up by
was he at third at one point?
Yeah, he was.
Up by eight, up by ten, all the way through.
He practiced it probably more than he did. So
I did later. Yeah. I guess now it's 1-on-1. So I got to practice.
Oh, yeah. And you practice big time.
Yeah, that was wicked though. Like I'm off. I need a cigarette. Is that 59? I was at 58. Like nobody's coming here. I gotta get out of here. I gotta go score those frags.
Yeah. Nothing wrong with being a red-blooded Canadian boy, is there? Right, Chief?
Yeah.
It's like yeah.
It's like wow.
Yeah.
Woo!
Yeah, I know. And I was like, and then there's Trigger Happy, eh?
Woo!
Me and him were like tied the whole game, eh? And I'm like, oh man. Are you Trigger Happy?
Yeah.
Good game, man.
Me and you are side by side, man. That was hot. Trigger.
Make sure you get some good Zoom views in here.
But hey, I know these three guys that are really kick ass that's in this tournament. Cheech, Lobot, and Raven Shadow, man, they're gonna kick ass. When you see the final standings, you tell me. These guys are gonna kick some ass.
Yeah? That's good. It's a good American. I got this fun wise here. I'm gonna fun.
Wanna bet?
Yeah, pretty.
Final?
Sure.
Okay, I'm gonna tell you a little secret. There's a pretty good chance that one of you three guys are gonna play Wombat or Fatality or True Joy or Xenon or or Elan or Power K and kick their ass. Yeah. That's all I can say.
That other guy's gotta play Wombat, Raven Shadow.
Gotta play Wombat?
Not one kill!
Not one!
Were you negative?
Negative three.
No, negative three.
Negative three to you. 50 something.
Hey, he's the top five in the world, man. You know, I mean, shit. You know.
Hey, man, that was the funniest game I've ever had.
So just kick ass and knock them out, man, and be somebody, and you'll be on that interview in the back on Gamer's Cast, and then next year you'll be on ESPN, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can't wait for the brackets to start tonight.
Do you believe that my being stronger or faster has anything to do with my muscles in this place? Do you think that's air you're breathing now?
Everybody in the North American continent has a real lust for violence. And Quake is awesome violent, you know? Like, you shoot a guy with the railgun and like it rains blood all over and a skull kind of like goes on the ground, you know? And, like, I remember the first time that I played Quake 3. I like, you know, stopped and like knelt down in front of the skull. I was like, wow, that looks great. You know? And it's, yeah, there's a real appeal to, like, inconsequential death, you know? Like, where you can, like, you know, go on a crazy killing spree and it doesn't have anything to affect with the real world.
I don't know, I feel
could have swore they proved that, like, wrong recently. I think there was a government report on that.
I think my opinion on this, that if you have problems to begin with, and you pick up Quake, you know, it might not turn out good. But, you know, most guys here, you know, they're just nice, normal, everyday people.
There's no explanation for it. Why kids go into school and shoot up other kids, or why people shoot people on the street for jackets and shoes. That's their own stupidity. It has nothing to do with gaming.
Most people here are intelligent enough to separate the violence from the game. It's just a game.
그런 생각 안 해요? 생 뭐 사회적인
Personally, it doesn't really bother me. I mean, like, it's just a game. But I mean, if there's something wrong with society, I guess, I mean, that he blames the society for it. But in Korea, Quake was banned for a long time until like 2 months ago, and now they just start shipping Quake Korean.
Because of the violence?
Because of violence, it wasn't in Korea, it was banned. So.
I haven't seen any violence here all day.
I'm just using video games as something to blame.
Yeah, exactly. Well,
someone needs to be blamed.
It's absolute horse shit. Let's see. Kids don't play for the gore anymore. They might get them into it, but it doesn't keep them there. It's, I don't even know it's the gore anymore. It's more about points or and strategy than anything.
I'm not gonna go out as other people. And, you know, that's... I play Quake. I play a lot of Quake. Most of these guys do. But, you know, I think some people have personal issues. And it's nice for the media and for everyone else to blame it on, you know, the movie industry, violent games, and etc. But it just depends on how you are yourself.
Bro, all these software companies that are getting sued by exes, mom in real life because, you know, oh, you turned my son into an efficient killer and blah, blah, blah. Whatever.
If people have a good life outside of the game world, if they have friends and family that support them and everything, that it's no big deal. I think it's only those who don't have anything else or whose life is messed up in some other way, you know, then it might be a bad influence.
I find that a lot of these teen killers in the media are not neglected, but the parents just don't know what's going on in their lives, and I think the video games are an outlet for them to point the finger at someone who's not them.
Idiots, you know, and it's idiots that you can't separate, you know, people that can't separate are, I think they're bent that way. They're not made that way, I think they're bent that way by something. It's not. Nothing makes them like that. I don't think that playing a video game like this will turn anybody into anything.
And what do you think about parents blaming computer games for all the violence and shit?
It's totally true. Why? God, I have no idea, but it's totally true. There was no games, there was no movies, kids had nothing to do but play soccer.
We should all keep the shooting on screen.
I'm not sure which one was first, but there's the PGL, the Professional Gamers League, and there's the OGL, which I know came after the PGL, and that's the Online Gamers League. And then there was this thing called Liga, and that's the one that I'm not sure came before the PGL or not. And that was just like another league. I don't know why it was called Liga. I think the guy with Kimball was from Germany or something like that, so maybe he just picked some Italian leagues here.
Liga was a joke. Liga was this German guy
Kimball. Oh my god. Okay, I'm sure there's 20 or 30 different sites dedicated to the lameness that is Kimball. Okay, yeah, it turned out to all be crap. There was one big nasty turning point where the guy that was more or less slated to win it all in North America, whose name is Immortal, young guy, really big Quaker. He just got kicked out of the league by Kimball, basically, because Kimball got his ass rocked.
CBL that stands for Cyber Athlete Professional League. CPL is all local events where it's just a LAN event. There's nothing done over the internet kind of thing. And that's one of the reasons I think it's so popular now, is because that's what true gaming is.
I founded the CPL on June 26th of 1997, and we did our first event the last weekend of October of 1997. And since then, this is our eighth event. It's the first one that's attracted gamers from 16 different countries, and it's the first one with a $100,000 cash prize, yes. First of all, you have to analyze Quake for what it is. Quake is really an evolution of Doom. Okay, so here's a game that has gone through several incarnations: Doom, Doom 2, Quake, Quake 2, Quake 3. But it's maintained a certain amount of consistency throughout that period of time. And what we like about that is the fact that the physics of the game, that the nature of the game has remained sort of unchanged, and there's an incredible community that has developed over that period of time. Is the league looking at other games? Absolutely. We are going to use other games. That we are not, you know, about world domination, but we're about pushing this to the level of a professional sport. I didn't want to Americanize gaming. So what I did instead is I partnered with people that were familiar with the scene or that wanted to start something in different parts of the globe. For example, our friends in CPL Europe and now CPL Asia, so they can develop the CPL from within the continents. And with an awareness of the cultural differences and what games they really want to play there and all that. So instead of us imposing our views to them, we just give them a set of standards and we help in the partnership and to promote it. And we allow the CPL to grow within those markets. To give you an example, we were just offered $65 million for the CPL. And we just said, there's no way, we're not going to do it. I tell you why. There's a couple of reasons, but the number one reason is I don't want to be the person that got it all started and quit just when it was starting to get hot. I really want to see this through. It's a personal goal of mine. And right now, what I'm talking to Coca-Cola and companies like Taco Bell and major Pizza Hut and all these other companies is to do the first $500,000 tournament. That's our next goal before we get to the $1 million tournament, which is my ultimate goal. Once we get there, it's all over. We are definitely a sport.
Yeah, all right.
Yo sé bien que estoy afuera, pero el día que yo me muera.
Making ourselves a pornographic movie. Texas guy.
Texas. Jeanette Papineau and Hughes. We're here doing a convention for the GOD, Gathering of Developers. We're promoting their game and our calendars.
Did you play video games at all?
Yeah, I like the older ones though, like Pac-Man, remember? It's love really it. Exciting. There's so many different people here, and they come up and they're excited because they just played a cool game.
Lots of cute guys here too.
Yes, I am. 15 girls will be here for this fiasco. It's going to be absolutely mind-boggling.
Pamper me, and baby. Texas.
So where are you guys hanging out tonight? Are you clubbing here?
You know, we're probably going to hang here.
And we got invited to a couple inside parties, but I don't think we're going to get
close. I got to get behind them.
Yeah, you gotta sign me one too.
Absolutely. What's your name?
It's Cheech.
Lillian, how do I know I find you here?
Because the chicks are here.
Yeah, my name is Henrik Bjork.
And you play under?
Blue.
All right. How long have you been playing?
I've been playing since the summer '98, I think. Oh, yeah, the Christmas '99, something like that. And my friends played it, so I was over at their house, and I thought it was fun, so I joined up.
What made you get so good, though?
Well, it's practice. All practice.
So how many hours a week?
Well, a week is like, some days it's like maybe 4 hours a day, and some none. So it's like, average, maybe 2 hours a day.
Oh, when I prepare for a tournament, probably like 5 hours every day. And then I just play for fun, you know, like a couple hours here and there.
On average, usually 2 hours a day. Sometimes I skip days on weekends, so probably like 10, maybe 12 hours.
Not much compared to these guys, so that's why I was really happy. Because I was only putting up an hour and a half or so a day.
He doesn't really play like not every day, but if when he does play, he plays about six or more hours every day.
Good.
About 30 minutes.
30 minutes? You're not playing much?
I don't play at all. That's why I suck.
Who do you think is going to take it now?
Fatality, no doubt.
No doubt?
It's all on
It's that good, huh?
Yeah, he's good at every map, so like some players are good at one map, but he's good at all of it. So.
It could be anyone. It could really be anyone. I know that the buzz is that Fatality is the one that's going to take it. A lot of people think Machiavelli's playing really well. A lot of people think the guys from Korea are looking good. You know, Blue is playing a phenomenal game. I just was amazed. It would be, you see Machiavelli's a very confident person.
I think Fatality has one more tournament in him where he's just probably going to whoop everybody. But because I mean, he's been playing nonstop, and these guys are just starting to, you know, really take it seriously. I mean, after looking at him, you know, then they're starting to, you know, see what kind of time is needed, and you know, the results they can get is like 40 grand in a day.
Banshee Beal. Stephanie Bergman.
And you guys are from?
All Games Network. And we co-host a weekly show called Lilith and Eve.
Lilith and Eve were the two first women, and Vanjie and I are the two first women to kind of be out there and publicly speaking about games for women.
I play actually pretty much everything from playing Crib on the MSN Gaming Zone. Right now, I mean, I play that a lot.
Hearts is the better game on the zone.
Yeah. But I also play like Unreal Tournament. Right now I'm playing Thief 2 a lot, quite a bit of playing that, and Nox.
I don't know of that many Tomb Raider players who are female, just because the image of Lara Croft is just so incredibly exaggerated. And I mean, some of the Quake 2 models are exaggerated. You know, you've got the big tits out to here and the 2-inch waist.
What's it like being, I guess, in a sort of male-dominated sport?
It's a little intimidating at first. It really is. I mean, one of the first gaming events I went to, I was just in this room and there was guys everywhere and all the girls kind of segregated and found each other. But you just take it in stride, and it's like kind of like you have to be willing to be one of the guys, so to speak, to kind of fit in with them.
Yeah, I mean, we like guys, obviously, so there's nothing wrong with being surrounded by a lot of them.
I like being a female gamer. And I think it's really cool that there are a lot of female gamers now, whereas a few years ago it would have been absolutely unheard of to think that women actually play these modern video games. But women have made a name for themselves in gaming now. So.
You know, I play games, and I happen to be a girl. I'm not, you know, I don't play Quake because I am a girl. So, you know, it's nice. Most guys, you know, that I play with, you know, respect me. You know, I try just very hard to get every, you know, good player's respect.
If you're a good game developer, you're pretty pragmatic about frame rates and things like that, and you've got all these ways kind of conditioned into your mind about, you know, you just don't do certain things because that's gonna suck. But you know, the truth is, things are so fast now that a lot of those things that you've conditioned yourself over years, it's like, no, you just couldn't possibly want to do that, are actually reasonable things to do. Because the thing that people always do when they're in front of a game, especially, well, the really serious players are all calm and collected and just sit there rock solid. But when you watch somebody new play one of these games, you know, they're constantly moving their head around and ducking and trying to see around the corner like that. And with a setup like that, you can actually do that. You know, it's Giga Earth DDR, you must be chugging really slow, and you've got to be on the greatest car with 2,000 yard shooters. This really is about the best odds to know. Per pixel shadows, on every light source, top map specular highlights, projected lights, and you know, multiple texture channels, and separate colored specular and all this stuff.
Because, like, you know, if you want to consider yourself the best, well, then you've got to build up your own rep.
I'm playing A Revelation from Clan Abuse. Yeah. I don't know. We'll see. He's really good. Really good. So. And then if I manage to actually squeak past him, I got to play Rix Rev, who's like the CPL champion from the first 2 years or something.
How are they choosing the map? Like, you pick one, and he picks one, and if they don't agree, then it goes random.
Yeah. So
between the two that you chose?
Yeah.
No, between all four.
Okay.
They roll a four sided.
Basically, I gave the guy a choice of three maps, and he didn't want any of them, so it went random. And then he still got the map he wanted anyways.
Which map are you going for?
I don't know. I'm open to DM 13. The thing is, one-on-one is all experience, so if they played hardcore free-for-all, and you know, they might have practiced at one-on-one a bit, but unless you practice one-on-one like 4 hours a day, you're not going to go far in the tournament in the one-on-one battle at all, because it's all experience and strategy, you know?
Yeah. It's his map, though.
Which map?
The M6.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I got it tough, but that gives me a chance to go for the glory.
I'm ready.
General strategy is basically, it's like one of the most important things is to be able to learn the other guy's style, like in the first few frags of the match. Look how he moves and see where he comes out with certain patterns that he likes to do kind of thing and play against those. If when he goes down this through this door, he always comes out of this hallway. Next time he goes down that door, shoot a rocket at that hallway. He comes there dead.
Man, they swarm! Every time, every single time.
Yoo-hoo! I'll make you famous.
I'm Christian's mother.
Okay. Addiction and a waste of time, she thinks.
I don't know. I think maybe Christian's a little bit old.
Shit.
Actually quite pleased that he was involved in a tournament that included people from all over the world. I thought it would be a great opportunity for him to meet interesting people.
It's really awesome. It's a cool place. Maybe I'll buy a cocktail.
What she doesn't like about Quake is she thinks it detracts from your social responsibilities to go out and find a wife and get married.
Oh, like finding a wife. Well, I like to tease Christian. I watch Christian play, though, and I can see he's in a high degree of concentration when he's playing. See a surgeon. I've watched many surgeons concentrating. And I believe that it's the same degree of concentration that is in play here. But I'm supportive in that it seems to be something he's very interested in.
If you were a 15-year-old kid and you were taking correspondence school or something like that, and you were really good at Quake, and you won that, that would mean like you could play Quake for like the next 3 years and live at home and get really, really good. And if there's prizes like that already, what's not to say that you could win another tournament for another 40 or 50 grand and then just sit on your ass and play Quake some more? I mean, like, you could become super ultra famous for playing a game that you like to play anyways.
The gaming industry has surpassed the movie industry as far as money making goes. Within the last couple of years, that's happened. I mean, that's huge amounts of money. And it will become a spectator sport.
It's a matter of people developing the taste as well. Christ, I've seen people watch TSN bowling for 4 hours. I mean, that absolutely baffles me.
My prediction,
the
year 2005, we'll see the first Quake player that actually earns $1 million
jobs to play
in
Quake.
1 year. And he plays Quake.
Let's get it on.
We actually took two models, and we took the PGA, and we took boxing because of the one-on-ones. We even have studied the World Wrestling Federation, which is not really a sport. It's just acting and entertainment. But they have done some things to get mass attention that we need to look at.
Is this going to be able to rival something like the NBA in terms of popularity?
That's a great question.
Not a chance. The game is always a new game. Nobody can master one game.
Not a chance.
Why not? If they're good at it, they can make money. Sure.
It's going to be big because I'm going to make it big. You have to really study the roots of the NBA and who brought them. What did they do to become so popular?
Maybe like 15 years from now. I mean, they got a long way to go, but obviously it's getting bigger and bigger, you know, every event. And I think they announced like a 250,000 event coming up within a year. And they're going to find their way into team play events pretty soon. And I really think team play is going to be a big part of it.
We are going to be moving into team games, and our goal is to have country tournaments where we have, you know, we're planning for for the last tournament of next year to have a tournament where every country is going to be charged with the responsibility of picking the four or five best gamers in their country and coming out for a team event where we definitely have USA versus UK versus Australia versus New Zealand versus, you know, and that's going to be a lot of fun. Canada. We're looking right here at, as far as the CPO is concerned, the best pro gamer in the world and the second best pro gamer in the world. These guys did a phenomenal game.
I think the biggest prize I won before this was $4,000. So this is a big increase.
How old are you guys?
I'm 20.
20?
19.
19. Awesome.
You guys got a tiger.
Hey, what's the tiger?
That's a tiger called Smoo. SMU. And it's short for smooth. My girlfriend gave it to me a while ago. I've been basically taking all my events. Took it to Stockholm, went 18-0 there, and came here.
I knew he put in a lot of practice for this event. All props deserved. I mean, he really worked to win this event. In the future, knowing that he puts in that much practice, I think I'm going to have to match him. And we'll see what's up. next time, it ain't going to be so easy, all right?
Our three winners, $70,000 is represented with these three individuals right now. From Razer, it's a nice crystal, not glass, crystal trophy. Please get a shot of this. This is unbelievable. These things are very nice. It says Razer Boom Slam, first place, Razer CPL event, the year 2000.
In every other sport, you might have to be big enough, you might have to be fast, strong, just to be recognized. But in this league, you got to use your mind, your hand, your eye coordination, to think. And also, when you play each other in these games, there's no referee, there's no cheating, there's no evaluation, there's no other man that can decide whether you win or lose. It's up to you. You are a true champion. You sit in a chair, use your mind, your hand, eye coordination, and be a champion in cyber athlete. Chair, mind. True champion in cyber athlete. You got to use your mind to think. You can sit in a chair. Use your mind, your hand, eye coordination. True champion. In every other sport, you might have to be big enough. You might have to be fast. But in this league, you got to use your mind. Chair, mind. True champion. Chair, mind. Cyber athlete.
Look at me!